All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, assalamu alaikum. A very good afternoon to all of you. And surprise, surprise, I'm hosting a show for you because usually I don't host shows on Fridays. But I'm here because I really wanted to talk about something very important. Now, before we jump towards a fantastic interview we have, you know, in store for you, I have a quote for you. And it goes something like this. Push yourself. Because no one else is going to do it for you. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this fantastic show. And this is courtesy of DGS. We have a fabulous, fabulous individual here. Now, the reason that I'm mentioning the word fabulous is because he has made an effort. He has broken the glass ceiling for a lot of people here in Pakistan as well because, you know, they always think about the fact that, achha, ab career ke baare mein sochna hai, to ab humne doctor banna hai. या इंजीनियर बनना है या हमने पायलट बनना है या हमने अगर मीडिया में जाना है तो क्या करें या अब्बू जान जो कर रहे हैं वो करें या अम्मी जान ने जो बोला है वो करें तो आई थिंक दैट फहद वुड प्रोबब्ली एग्री विद मी अस्सलाम वालेकुम फहद अजीम हाउ आर यू वेलकम टू द शो गुड आफ्टरनून
वालेकुम सलाम थैंक यू सो मच सोफी फॉर हैविंग अस
इट्स अ प्लेजर इट्स अ प्लेजर
एब्सोल्युटली आई एग्री विद यू
ओके फैंटास्टिक लेट मी जस्ट ऑफिशियली एंड फॉर्मली इंट्रोड्यूस यू एज वेल सो बेसिकली यू आर द मैनेजर ऑपरेशंस एट डीजीएस एंड यू नो आई हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स दैट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर ऑलवेज मेंशनिंग द फैक्ट दैट इफ यू want to go up the ladder, you have to face failure. And failure is a stepping stone towards success. Your thoughts on it?
No, absolutely. I agree. See, in order for you to actually feel better when you get the success, you have to firstly know what it feels like to actually get back up again.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, as your quota for the day, it actually ties up really nice into our conversation.
Yeah.
You have to push yourself.
Yeah.
And everybody's faced that in our, you know, in this, in your once or twice in your career, you have to face that failure. And you know, I've done that as well. Everybody starts from the bottom, and you have to work your way up step by step.
Absolutely.
By step. And I think failure, it's a few people take it very, very seriously to them. And that drives them to do even better.
So true. Absolutely.
So I think that's very important for yourself to accept that, you know, not everything, everything's not going to go your way all the time. Accept it, work around it, and get back up there.
Absolutely. As they say, it's not always about love and butterflies all the time. You got to face the music also. Okay, so coming to your profile also, and I was taking a look at your profile, and mashallah, at a young age, you've achieved quite a lot also. You studied abroad, you came back to Pakistan also, and at the age of, you know, in your 20s, in your late 20s, you've managed to be happily married. We're going to talk a little bit about the happily married part though. Okay, this needs a lot of interesting discussion. I can see you smiling right there, Fahad. And then
it's
also,
it's a wicked smile.
It's a wicked smile. बिल्कुल जो दर्द भरी स्माइल है ना जो कुछ बोल नहीं सकते वो इनकी जुबान पर आ नहीं सकता एंड देन ऑफ कोर्स इफ यू टॉक अबाउट योर करियर एट डीजीएस आल्सो हाउ डिड इट बिगिन हियर इन पाकिस्तान टेल अस अबाउट द जर्नी
You know, as you started off with, in the earlier age, there's not much guidance that we normally get. I was the only sibling that I was here. My parents, they generally
just... Beta.
Eklota
beta. Hamara eklota beta.
Yeah. I have an elder brother. He's abroad, though. So I didn't have the brotherly, elderly guidance that I had. It was basically just parents, you know what, study, do everything, stuff. So I started off with the general... pre-engineering part.
Okay.
That, you know, you go into studies, do pre-engineering, beta engineer banega. But I never kind of...
Papa kehte hain, bada naam karega.
I never liked it. You know, it wasn't something that it was I wanted to do.
Okay.
So from engineering, I moved around. I started looking at what should I do. So I moved into accounting.
Okay. All right.
Moved into numbers, because that kind of numbers I like. You know, so that kind of picked up. After a while, though, you know, something... You get bored of sitting at home. You want to do something. And that's something that I wanted to do. My parents normally didn't ask me, you know, go look for a job. But that was something that I wanted to do on my own.
That's great. That's great.
I wanted to go ahead and look, you know, keep myself busy.
Right.
So worked in some sort of a travel consultancy for 2 months. But it was too far away from my house. So I was like, you know, that's not even worth it.
Okay.
But then a friend actually recommended me to DGS.
Okay.
At that time, it was TRG at that time.
Right.
It was known as TRG, so...
And very famous. I mean, everyone knew about TRG.
Everybody knew about TRG. And that was really intimidating.
Right.
When my friend told me, hey, you know what? You should apply for TRG. For a second, I was like, are you serious? You want me to go to TRG?
Talk about pressure. Right.
And so, and I... To that day, I'm really thankful for that person because he was actually the one who actually got me to the door.
Right.
He's like, you know what? Go ahead and give your
interview. That's where the journey started.
That's where the journey started.
So now that you know, we've talked about your journey also, now comes your entrance and your entry towards, you know, TRG also, as it was known back in the day. So what did you learn and what was the atmosphere like?
When I initially joined, the atmosphere was, it was very welcoming.
Okay.
In the same way, when you stepped in the door, it was very professional. You had to be on your best behavior. You had to dress right, speak right.
Right.
And I was only 20 at the time when I joined. So for me, you know, wearing trousers, going to college, doing and all of a sudden I have to straighten up.
Yeah,
for me,
professional.
It was a big learning curve. And the reason I say intimidating is because TRG at that time was in Ivanic Bar. So that itself, it's a really, you know, it's a
empowering
big building,
kind
empowering.
Of, yeah.
You go there and you're like, okay, so this is where I have to go every day.
Yeah, yeah.
But yes, that experience, it's made me more mature. It's made me more open to things. I've had a lot of awareness, how to speak, how to greet people, how to be professional, how to carry yourself, basically.
I think this is wonderful, and I'm sure so many people had different questions also. So we can take questions as well people. Yeah, so all you need to do is type in FM space and name a comment and send it across to 333. You can WhatsApp us as well on 0315-111-9191. A very good afternoon to all of you. My name is Sophie. It's a very special show. We're talking about DGS. Have you seen Scrubs?
Absolutely. Who hasn't seen
I know,
Scrubs?
Right? So you like TV show seasons?
Yes, definitely. Scrubs is one of my shows that I actually grew up watching. It was one of the initial comedy seasons that you got.
Yeah. So what are you watching these days?
I'm actually doing a rerun of How I Met Your Mother again.
Are you?
I just finished Friends. So these are the few seasons that I love watching again.
You can never get enough of Friends, though, that's for sure. Brilliant. So the reason I was asking about Scrubs is because I remember the track called I'm No Superman. So, you know, sometimes, you know, you don't really have to be who people want you to be. You have to be yourself as an individual. That's very important. So this is going out specially to everybody's tune in. Once again, welcome to a very special show and good afternoon. All right, what a fantastic track there was. And it was, of course, you know, from the theme called, the theme was actually about doctors and it was all medical, but it was from the TV show called Scrubs. It was called I'm No Superman. And we are joined here by Fahad Azeem. Assalamu alaikum once again. Fahad, good afternoon to you. And so many people are asking us different questions pertaining to DGS as well, okay? And a lot of people are also looking for jobs. So they feel that if there's an opportunity, perhaps, and maybe you could guide them?
No, absolutely. See, DGS is generally all the time we're hiring.
Okay.
So we're looking for new talent. We're looking for people actually coming to work.
Right.
We're also conducting walking interviews nowadays.
Okay.
So you can show up to our office at DGS. It's on Google Maps as well.
Okay.
From 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. in the evening. So we have walk-in interviews.
Okay.
If you're unable to come, you want to schedule, you can also call at 111-DGS-DGS.
Okay.
Our recruitment line is open. You can ask them questions. They'll take a over-the-phone interview, and they actually schedule you for one as well.
Okay, sure.
So we're consistently looking for people who are hungry to work.
Okay, so I have a question, which is a very generic question, because probably everyone asks the same question. But, you know, it's a little cliched as well. Is there a specific criteria? I mean, what exactly are you looking forward to when it comes to recruitment?
That's actually one of the best parts, I would say, about DGS. There's no set criteria. You don't have to be a certain height, weight, age. You know, we hire people from...
Yeah. What does that even mean?
You know, nowadays, for...
Who has that criteria?
Yeah. I remember my wife went for an interview for Shaheen Airlines. And they were like, you know what, you're these many pounds overweight. And I was like, you know what, let's just go back home. So that's one of the best parts. We hire people from all backgrounds. You don't have to have anything. The only thing that we look for is the ability to communicate properly in the English language.
Okay.
That's all we need.
Okay.
If you're able to properly communicate, you can convey your message across.
Right.
You're actually there to work.
So clarity and pronunciation has to be clear.
Exactly.
Right?
So
okay.
That's the only thing that we look for.
Okay, great. So we have more messages also. I think Faisal Ali Khan had the same question because, you know, he was looking for a job and he's asking us as well. And then we have a message from Hasnain JB who says, good going, Fadi.
Yeah, I think JB just got free from work as well.
Okay, great. Behram says, salam to all. Walaikum assalam. Thank you so much for joining us. So now, coming back to, you know, career counseling now, because I started the show by talking about this also. Career counseling Pakistan mein bahut kam aapko nazar aati hai. Kyun aur kya kar sakte hain hum iske liye?
I think awareness abhi tak, you know, us level pe nahi aayi hai. Right now, har koi, it's a race. Har koi chah raha hai ki main padhai mein first aa jaun, ye first kar loon, maine acche marks lene.
So grades matter.
Grades matter nowadays,
right,
rather than ke substance kya hai un grades ka. What do you actually know? Grades lena now, and I think it's maybe the culture that we've developed or we've taken on from other people, or it's the pressure, I would say, that it's being put on our youngsters nowadays.
Right, right.
That you have to get good grades in order to be successful.
Right.
And I think, yes, grades matter. Lekin, what you've actually learned, what you do with your life matters more.
Right.
So you can have all the best grades in the world, but if you can't actually carry a conversation with anybody, you know, you don't have the confidence, those grades aren't going to matter.
You know, I'm going to tell you something. So perhaps this is a conversation almost everybody does tend to have also. I remember having this conversation with one of my colleagues also, that I remember all my sort of schoolmates from back in the day who used to get amazing grades. They were number one or number two or number three. Sadly, they're not doing that great in their professional life. And I still remember that a lot of students who were average, but they're doing exceptionally well in the professional field. So your academic grades, I don't think they matter a lot when it comes to your professionalism. What do you think?
No, absolutely. Professionalism, you have to... grooming is very much necessary.
Itna pressure nahi dalna chahiye na ki pehli position hasil karni hai. I mean, aptitude bhi to dekhna chahiye na insaan ka, because bachche ghabra jate hain phir wo peer pressure mein bhi aa jate hain. So coming back to DGS also, of course, you know, it provides a platform for individuals of all age groups also. So when you get into DGS, what is the plan for the future, for the next decade?
As far as when you get into DGS, if you've come with the mindset that, you know, this is the place that you're going to work, the doors are open for you. It doesn't matter wherever you want to go. Everybody normally thinks about, you know, whenever we talk about DGS or customer service, perception kya hota hai ki ek chota sa kamra hoga, baith ke wahan pe call le rahe honge log. And that's really, I think that's really wrong. Not a lot of people have the awareness ki kitni badi industry hai.
True.
And that's what we're trying to actually get people to know. You know, it's, we have a finance department. We have an administration department. We have recruitment.
Right.
We have marketing. We have IT.
Specialized departments. Okay.
We have HR. And that, those are departments where you can grow.
Right.
And the best thing is that DGS hires internally.
Okay.
Majority of their hiring that they do in all these departments is done internally.
Oh, okay.
So all of our people, all of our sales executives, you know, the frontliners that we have who start off from the phones, they get the first opportunity to apply.
This is lovely.
And, you know, we've grown up off the ranks as well. When I joined, I started off the phones like everybody else does.
Right. So this was about 7-8 years ago,
seven,
right?
7-8 years ago.
Okay.
Our marketing director, he started off from the phones where we are.
Because,
all of the managers.
Yeah, because I feel that, you know, whenever you get yourself involved in any organization or a job for that matter, you really have to think about the future, that, you know, aapki growth kis tarah ho rahi, where do you see yourself, say, 10 years from now? And I think this is wonderful. Time for us to jump towards another track. Do you remember the track called You Gotta Be by Desiree? I think it's a beautiful track. And it talks about, you know, there are so many hurdles that come across in your life also, how you learn to tackle them. So the number to text in is very simple. It's all you need to do is type in FM space, your name, your comment, and send it across to 833. Aap hame WhatsApp bhi kar sakte hain on 0315-111-9191. Stay with us. Alright, what a fantastic track. There was Desiree, of course, at the song called You Gotta Be Fahad. Did you like the lyrics to the song?
Absolutely. I was actually very zoned out and listening to those lyrics, because it really hits to you that you have to go ahead and work hard and do,
I know, right?
Get down to business when you have,
to be stronger and you have to be wiser. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so we are in conversation with Fahad Azeem, who happens to be the manager operations here at DGS. We're talking about career counseling at the same time also, and about job opportunities as well, how to build up a good professional career. So coming to a very important question now, aapko pata hai ke females ke liye it's very, very important, specifically here in Pakistan, to make sure that not just themselves but also their family members are okay and comfortable with their working space, right? So how do you tend to tackle that at DGS?
I think that's actually very important nowadays, especially, you know, the environment that we try to create for our employees.
It has to be safe, of course.
Safe,
yes.
Secure, welcoming. It has to be a fun place for people to come and work and not feel like they would not be appreciated.
Right.
And, you know, getting females to a workplace is actually really hard. And the way that we're tackling it nowadays is...
Why do you feel it's hard?
The reason being, I think we haven't gone to that place yet.
Okay.
Where it's openly acceptable for females to go out work, especially during night shifts.
Okay.
One of the things about DGS is that, yes, we work afternoon to late evening to night shifts.
Yeah.
That's the where our majority of the work is done.
Yes.
In order to get people in, that's why we have these recruitment drives.
Right.
Where our gates are open 24/7.
Okay.
And whenever somebody wants to apply, if there are any sort of reservations from their family side, we ask them to bring them along.
Of course.
Bring them to the office. Show them what it's like.
Give them a tour and tell them what it's all about.
Our security is top notch. We've revamped the security.
Okay.
There are guards on every gate. There are check-ins to make sure that only employees can actually enter. If you're not an employee, you need to firstly be approved and get a visiting badge.
Okay.
And especially the production floor. If you're not an employee, you're not going to get to the production floor.
Right.
So we want to make sure that it's very safe and secure for our employees.
Absolutely. So we have a question. Okay, this one has been sent in by Sadaf, and she's asking us, okay, so what about the pay scale? I'm not sure we're going to talk about the pay scale right here, sister, but let's see what we can do about that. Let's talk overall about the lucrative packages and generally what people can get once they enroll themselves into DGS. Yeah?
As far as, that's, I think, one of the perks that DGS gives out.
Yeah.
It's the one of the reasons why people come and join is because of, you know, in monetary terms,
we give out
a lot of cash, just to say.
Okay.
And that's the way in sales.
Show me the money.
Yeah, show me the money. You know.
Okay.
In sales, the better you are, the more money you make.
Right.
You know, everything is based off of commission in sales, and DGS is known for having one of the highest payouts that there is. If we, you know, just to give you a rough idea, the top 20% of our sales force, the top 10% of our sales force, they take home more than six figures on a monthly basis.
Wow,
and they don't even break a sweat.
That's amazing.
It's because they've been there for a while, they've put in the time, and they've gotten so good at it.
Right.
It's really fun. It's a good place to work. And yes, it pays out very handsomely.
Fantastic. Thank you for answering that. Another thing, we have a lot of other perks at DGS as well. You know, you have the medical insurance to go with it, the leave quota, Provident Fund, of course, the company transport, healthy working environment, in-house training and development. And I think, but the one thing that is primarily required is commitment and dedication, which is very important. So now let's come to a very interesting question, which might turn out to be a debate or a discussion as well at the same time. So, see, whenever people come to different organizations to look for a job, they want to get the best of everything, but they're not willing to put in all that kind of hard work and commitment and dedication. And they tend to jump a lot when it comes to different sort of career options and job opportunities. What do you think, you know, working with the youth today here in Pakistan, what has your experience been so far?
As far as getting people to actually stay, it starts off from the interviews that we take.
Yeah.
So operations, recruitment, we normally sit side by side when we're taking interviews. And what we try to judge, and we ask them the same questions.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what brought you here?
Right.
What's the mindset? Why did you come to, actually, what got you working in, you know, in DGS?
Sure. Is there an aim, something you're looking forward to?
And that's what we try to instill. That's the first step. That's what we try to go ahead and put in their mind. And we tell everybody, you know what, I started off from where you were 7-8 years ago.
Right.
I put in the time and look where I am.
Right.
Career growth is going to be there.
Right.
But nobody's going to come, as again, I go back to your quote, nobody's going to come and do it for you.
You have to do it yourself.
You have to do it yourself.
Right.
And we have all the tools that you need. We have our recruitment who gets you in the door.
Mm-hmm.
We have experienced trainers who actually get you ready for the job.
Right.
We have our ABA department who, and our supervisors. All of them are there in order to make sure that you do your best. So we want to provide you with all the tools that you need. But again, nobody's going to come and use those tools for you.
Sure.
You're the one who has to actually, at the end of the day, get the job done.
Sure. So we have a comment for you. Okay, this one has been sent in by Harris Javid. I have a feeling all your friends
are somehow watching/listening
to the show today. And he says that the best resource one can ever have, the one, the only, Fahad Azeem. Love you, bro.
Well, yeah, Harris was a great friend as well. He actually got another opportunity, so he currently works in Rosie as well nearby.
Okay.
But yeah, he was a lovely gem of a guy as well.
Okay, fantastic. I see you have a good support system there. So let's play another track. Since we're playing a lot of inspirational/motivational songs, how about Vital Signs with the track called Do Pal Ka Jeevan?
You know,
it's a great song with a fantastic message also. And you guys are taking a listen to a very special show. Good afternoon, Assalamu Alaikum. My name is Sophie. And it's a special show, courtesy of DGS. We're talking about career opportunities and job opportunities as well. Do not go anywhere. Stay with us. All right, what a fantastic track. That was by Vital Signs, of course, Do Pal Ka Ye Jeevan. And it had some amazing lyrics, but you know, my favorite part is that if you lose, then you will enjoy the win. And if you lose, then you lose. It's such beautiful lyrics and fantastic melody, of course, coming out from Vital Signs. Ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu Alaikum, a very good afternoon to you. My name is Sophie, and with me, I have Mr. Fahad Azeem. He is the manager operations, quite a big shot here at, of course, DGS. So coming back to the point, now, we have talked about a lot of things. You know, we've talked about career counseling. We've talked about how it's a safe environment for females as well as for males also, the youth as well in particular. And now, let's come to the basic thing, okay, which is that aap Pakistan mein बहुत सारे लोग होते हैं जिनके ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस में कुछ रूल्स होते हैं जिसपे लोग ओबे भी करते हैं, कुछ रूल्स होते हैं जो लोग कहते हैं हमें समझ नहीं आते ये रूल्स क्या हैं. सो हाउ वुड यू लाइक टू डिफाइन डीजीएस, यू नो, एज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन रूल बाय रूल?
I think every organization, and if you want to be a successful organization and company, if you want to grow...
Like a vision, you know?
Like a vision. You have to have a vision, you have to have a goal and aim to go. Hamara bhi vision, it's fairly simple. We have it displayed all over. It's, you know, it's really hard to remember, but
okay.
It's okay. To be the preferred digital customer and lead acquisition company.
Right.
And it ends with... where the work we do makes the people we interact with better.
Nice.
So the purpose behind it is...
I'm glad you remember most of it.
Yeah, I remember. So we want to be at the top.
Right.
And in order for us to get there, we want everybody who's working with us to also be at the top.
Right.
And yes, you have to follow rules and regulations. It's not there to stop you from doing something.
Yeah.
It's there to get you into that mindset.
Right.
That you're at work.
Right, absolutely.
You can have fun at work as well, but there are certain things you have to follow.
Hmm.
You know, you can be coming to work in a tank top, chappal pehen ke bhi main kaam
karta. Of course.
You know, those type of smaller things. So rules and regulations, I believe they're very important for any company.
Right.
For us, it's dependability, adherence. And at the end, everything falls into two things, time management and commitment. If you have those two things, those rules are a piece of cake.
Right, absolutely. So a very interesting question now coming your way, that, you know, at a very young age, you, mashallah, happen to be a successful professional, also happily married, and you have a settled life also. But a lot of people who are in their late 20s or even early 30s, even mid-30s for that matter, are sometimes still confused in life because they feel, hey, you know what, we don't know what we're doing in life. Do we have an aim? Are we looking for something? What would be a pearls of wisdom? How do you think that, you know, how would you tackle this situation? What would be your advice to them?
I think what we normally do is we start to think too much.
Right.
That,
like, overthinking?
Overthink.
Yeah.
We start to overthink things.
Right.
Ke yaar ye karunga to kya hoga, wo karunga to kya hoga. And overthink karte karte, we never take a step.
Right. Like, what if this happens?
What if this happens?
Right.
And the worst thing that everybody, lo kya kahenge, wo kya kahenge.
Logo ka to kaam hai kehna.
So I think that's one of the things, in during my initial time, that was me as well.
Right.
I was blank, I had no guidance, and I was just walking what to do. And I think you need the right crowd around you. You need the right people to motivate and push you.
Yes, good company is very important.
Good company is very important.
Right.
You have to be social, but in the right type of social, where people would help you grow rather than help you...
Not just the social media, Insta-social, if you know what I'm saying. Yes.
And yes, you know, during my earlier career in DGS as well, you know, I was on the phones. It took me almost 3.5-4 years to actually get another position.
Right.
And so you have to face the failure. You have to face the rejection. You're not always going to get everything that you wanted.
Absolutely.
But that should drive you. Rather than demotivate you, that should drive you. You know what? Achha is bari nahi mila, watch what happens next.
You know what? This reminds me of a quote that don't stop when you're tired. Stop when you're done. So it's very important, you know, where there comes a point in your life you feel, you know what, I say I'm going to give it all up. That's it. You know, I'm quitting. That's the point when you should realize, hey, you know what? No, I'm not a quitter. I'm a go-getter.
So it's the one more step.
Right.
The one more step, the last push, that's always needed. And my word of advice would be to stop overthinking things until and unless you actually get into something, even if that something isn't what, you know, if it doesn't pan out, well, at least you did something.
Sure.
You got to know. It's better than staying at home and then just thinking, what should I do?
Yeah, absolutely. I would agree with that. All right. So, well, let's jump towards another track. I think we have a time check as well. And that should be followed by the track called Don't Stop Believing by Journey, a fantastic band and great lyrics. Do you like the song?
Absolutely. I love this.
Yeah,
I think. Especially the way it goes.
Yeah. And I think another track that we might just couple it up, maybe play back to back. Do you remember the track? Of course you do. Eye of the Tiger by Survivor.
Who doesn't know Eye of the Tiger?
I know.
If you're a Rocky fan, you're going to watch Eye of the Tiger.
I know. Even if you're like gymming or even if, you know, you're trying to be motivated in life, you know, Eye of the Tiger it is for sure.
It pumps you up.
Yeah, absolutely it does. So we have a message from Zamir, and he says, "Assalamu alaikum, Sophie, how are you? Walaikum assalam." He's enjoying the show and he wishes you all the very best.
Thank
and he
so
wishes
much.
The team at DGS all the very best as well. Thank you so much, Zamir. Right now, a short commercial break coming your way, followed by a back-to-back. Do not go anywhere. Stay with us. A very good afternoon. All right, what a fantastic back to back. There was Journey with the track called Don't Stop Believing. That was followed by Survivor with the track called Eye of the Tiger. Assalamu alaikum, ladies and gentlemen. A very good afternoon to all of you. Time on the dial is 4:52, and I shall be with you for the next, I guess, 7 to 8 minutes. Thank you so much for joining us. And we have a message from Zarfasha Azmat, and she is sending in a lot of prayers and love. Thank you so much for that, Zarfasha. Big shout out to you as well. Thank you so much for joining us. So, Fahad Azeem, of course, was talking to us about DGS. We were talking about career counseling and how to basically make a very good professional career here in Pakistan. Before signing out, any famous last words?
Well, I would actually just want to go ahead and speak out to everybody listening in and somebody who's actually wanting to work, get themselves going.
Sure.
And I would say, you know what, DGS is actually a place where you should definitely come, check out. And I think this can really help you grow as a person also. One of the things that we have to offer, you know, apart from the good environment, apart from the pay structure, the thing that we pride ourselves on is it's the grooming that we give.
Right.
You become mature in this. You get to learn how to interact with clients. You get to learn how to interact with your peers.
Which is so important that people ignore this part, actually. Yeah.
You know, in order for you to grow professionally, you know, it's not just the job that you need. You know,
right.
You can get any job, but that's not going to help you grow as a person.
Sure.
DGS helps you grow as a person. It gets you to manage your time. It gets you to learn how to deal with targets, how to deal with pressure, how to interact with people overall. And it really helped me grow as a person also. I, you know, and I don't shy away from saying this. I was a skinny little kid when I joined. And, you know, my mentor sitting right here, I'm sure he can vouch for that.
We give a shout out to your mentor also.
Yeah, shout out to my mentor, Wayne Braganza, recruitment head. So,
yo.
As far as when I joined, I knew there was a lot of things that I didn't know how to do.
Right.
And the only reason I got to know that is because I stuck around. I wanted to learn. I wanted to get there. And I think every organization, the only way you can grow is if you give back to your employees. And one of the ways we give back is the experience that they
get. Right, right. You know, another thing that a lot of organizations, they don't think about the fact that also it's very important for your employees to be very relaxed, you know, the environment that they work in, the productivity really needs to matter also. And then seldom you have organizations that actually have a retreat for the employees as well, so for people who work for them. And I've heard that you guys actually take them out for a holiday, which works best. So it's a win-win situation.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's actually a very big motivational factor that we have. You know, obviously in sales, everybody's fighting for something. Everybody wants to be at the top.
Of course. There's a target to be achieved.
There's a target to be achieved. And for DGS, if you get to that top, you know, we want to make sure that everybody knows who you are.
Right.
And one of the ways that we do that is we have international trips.
Right.
For the past 3 years, we've been taking our top performers on international trips. We've been to Malaysia. Last year, we went to Sri Lanka. A few years before, we also took them to Dubai.
Right.
And this year, we're also having an international trip, and I'm pretty sure that's going to be in Jamaica. We're going to be taking our individuals, and it's not just the people who are in the sales department.
Right.
We want to make sure everybody in the company is recognized. So we take people from all different departments.
This is
training,
wonderful.
From our quality department, from marketing.
Right.
So that way, as a company, everybody grows.
So you rotate.
We rotate.
Okay.
So this keeps everybody towards the same aim. And the aim is for the company to grow. Because eventually, you know, the company grows, you know, we grow.
Absolutely. And I think it's very important for companies to care about the employees, because that gets them motivated also. And they really feel like putting their best foot forward and working quite hard also. Thank you so much, Fahad. It was a pleasure. I wish you all the very best. And hopefully, inshallah, you would be, I don't know, stepping up also, making new milestones for people to sort of follow up as well. And let's play the last track. Let's dedicate it, okay, to somebody maybe. Okay, who would you want to dedicate the song to? Let's play Junoon for you.
Junoon.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure my wife's listening in. So I'd
he
like
just
to
wants
go
to play it safe, okay? He started off by saying hello to his wife, and he ended up the show by saying hello to his wife as well, okay? We know you love your wife. It's all sorted. We know you're going to go home safe and sound. Don't you worry, Fahad.
I'll dedicate this to Wayne. He's the one who actually brought me here.
Okay.
And got me into this job. So I'll dedicate this to my mentor, Wayne.
Okay, fantastic.
Thank you so much for the time, Sophie.
It was a
really
pleasure.
Fun.
It was a pleasure. And as for the rest of you, just remember that DGS has a lot to offer. If you want to know more details, you can always join their Facebook page, their website as well. Would you want to give the details to your website?
Yeah, it's if you go to DGSworld.com, you can go ahead and see our general website. We have a Facebook page, Digital Globe Service, Prime and Limited. You can call us at 111-DGS-DGS as well. And I'll let
Wayne
tell you.
Yes, your mentor wants to say something.
Yeah, our Facebook page is @DGSworld.pk. And looking forward to see a lot of like and shares, because we would like you all to be up to date with what we do here.
Absolutely.
Back to Fahad.
Okay, great. So I think that's about it. And I think we'll be jumping towards the last track. And as always, I shall be back with the show called Drive On with Sophie this Monday, 5 p.m. And the quote that I'll be signing out with is quite an interesting one. It goes something like this. Take a listen very carefully. When life puts you in tough situations, don't say, why me? Say, try me.
Very nice.
All right. So have a great evening, everybody. See you guys soon. Bye-bye. See you guys soon. Bye-bye. See you guys soon. Bye-bye. See you guys soon. Bye-bye.